sound. Oh, and the game cut out. Yeah, it's back. Yeah, you guys hear it too. All right, this is Anvil, top-down action roguelike game, and it is right now available on Steam as like an early demo kind of thing. I don't know. You can download it. It is a roguelike action kind of, you know, RPG. Plays very similar to Diablo, but it has like permanent upgrades. It has cool characters you can unlock. Right now I'm playing as Elsa. She's Elsa number 4 because I died out of there 4 times. But you can play as different characters that all have different special abilities. I'm playing as Elsa because she's got them thick thighs. And I'm working my way to unlock all the female characters because Uzi here has the thickest thighs, as you can see. I don't know, maybe Shuri does. Nah, Uzi does. Anyway, there's other characters as well. There's Jungler, there's Sandman, there's Lightning. Oh, he looks pretty cool. Mountain, Guillotine, Liner, Rush. Well, he looks dope. And Toast. So yeah, I'm going to mess around with this character. She starts off with some interesting abilities. She summons a giant beast. She can freeze people. But if you go to the frozen planet, and your planets are random too, if you go to the frozen planet, it doesn't work on them. It looks like you can unlock little side robots to come with you, and they give you bonus abilities, but they're very expensive. And then there's permanent upgrades you can get, and they're very expensive as well. You actually have to play a lot in this game. And there's two-player co-op. I'm not sure if they're going to expand further and do more player co-op, but for now I'll just do the single player. Oh, I got the ice planet right off the bat. Great. This means my freeze ability is probably not going to work. And one more complaint I will have immediately, right off the bat. It takes way too long to blow up these chests. But the gameplay feels really cool. Especially when you get cool guns like this right off the bat. What did I just pick up? What are these guns? Indra handgun. Powerful handgun that fires lightning rounds to shock enemies. Electrifies targets. Skill power increased by 40%. Hell yeah. I'll take that. Oh, there we go. Blows those up right away. So this is a permanent upgrade you can get for the run. I don't need this, so just a tip. The game plays very fast and very cool. And it looks really good. Oh. This is a gun that could use an ammo upgrade. Health pickup there. And then there's random chests throughout the stage where you'll get, this is where you get the bulk of your power. Increase attack by 50% when HP is 80% or higher. That's really good. Ignore enemy's defense and we'll save up for something else next time. Oh, this gun breaks those chests right away. But yeah, when I'm playing it on a controller, it plays like a twin stick shooter, which is pretty neat. Looks like the teleporter is there, but I can't go that way. Let's see. Reduce debuff duration by 50%. Reduce skill cooldown by 1 second when taking damage. Reduce survival skill cooldown by 10%. I think I'll take that for now and save my points for the next one. Survival skill, of course, is your dash. Ooh, what's this? Increase weapon power, Swabski is plus one, that's really good. Increase attack power three when taking damage, stacks 100 times. I mean, I don't like taking damage, so. I'll just give myself a survival skill boost. I just noticed there's an arrow telling me to go. This gun is so good. Anything to break? Nothing. Crit chance by 30%. That's really good. I had a really good run before where I got to the fifth boss. There's five bosses in a run. Not five bosses, sorry. There's five stages in a run. And not really showing off her skills here, I'm sorry. I'm kinda killing everything with this gun. I'll do this. She summons a giant wolf. Not wolf, sorry, a giant worm monster. And that's her freeze, but it doesn't work on the monsters in the frozen thing, so I'm kinda gimp. Boom! That's the first stage. Next planet. Sometimes it's just a boss as well, and not just a planet, like a stage like that. Like, this is just a boss. Larger beam. Let's do the larger beam. I haven't done that one yet. Because my freeze is not going to work on this guy. Oh. This is the first time fighting this boss, so I don't know what he's capable of. Oh. One thing I will say is I wish the enemies would show up on the minimap. It's a longer beam, that's for sure. Ooh, perfect dodge. Big alien, help me out. See, and he kind of taunts him. Melted. Get wrecked. All those are good. I'll take them all. These next two ones look like stages and not just bosses, so. Hopefully I'll get some good upgrades for the fifth boss. I mean, look at this. Come on. What in the world? Alright, so my freeze can actually work on these guys, so let me see, increase attack speed 50%, 5 seconds of teleporting, that's really good, I'll try that. That's insane. What do we got here? Increased crit chance by 30% when HP is 30% or lower. Critical hit damage increased by 50%. Max health. Okay. The teleporter. Guns. Max HP is increased by 40%, critical hit chance increased by 20%. Handguns that fire guided penetrating lasers. Oh, interesting. Not sure which one would be better. Well, let's try that out. And I will come back for these if these don't, you know, work out. Never mind, they're good. Cover 5% HP one is really good. I had it on a run before, and it helped me a lot. Actually, all of these are good. Reload. Interesting that there's a fog of war. I kind of. Boom! Melted. I won't buy anything in that shop. Since I'm going to the next stage, I might as well save up. Oh, what's this? Oh, I guess I should check every shop. Shield are active. That might help. Or maybe not, I don't know. Well, there's that one I'm gonna aim for that. And increase attack power by 30% shields are active, I already have. So, what am I supposed to do? Guard the relic probe, annihilate approaching enemies, activate turret. Oh, that was close. Damn it, I got knocked down. I did it. All right, this fifth planet. I don't know if I can do this. This music's starting to kick into high gear. Oh, these are all good. I'm gonna take this though. Haven't fought this boss yet. Oh, damn, look at my HP already. Fuck! This is what happens. I get the guy down to like 1 HP and then they just start going cracked. And I'm not paying attention to my HP. Damn it, man, I almost melted that guy. Ah, oh, what an idiot. Oh, it's such a good build, too. Elsa number 5. Elsa number 99. Eventually. Let's give one of the other breakers a try that I've unlocked. Shuri! I'll keep trying the first area and get my butt kicked. Oh, this looks sick. I'm not a big fan of her gun, though. Yeah, you can't turn when you're doing that. She has a heal though, so she might be a little easier. Let's increase the recovery effect. Give me some pretty good music. Wow, these are all good. I'll be getting rid of this gun as soon as I can, basically. As soon as the new one pops up, because it's not very good. HP every 5 seconds or something? Is that what I'm getting? Damn it. Another thing I don't like is, these guns all have the same sound effects every single time. Reduce skill cooldown by 1 when taking damage. Invincible for 57 HP is below 30%. Reduce damage taken by 10%. Yeah, let's do that. She seems pretty tanky, so I'm gonna see if I can tank her up a bit. Incoming game. Warning. Incoming game. How dare you knock me down? Guns seem pretty rare. Alright, I'll see how I fare against this boss, I guess. I don't know. Let's see how I do against this boss. Alright. Increase radius 1.5 times. Reduce cooldown by 30%. Increase damage to petrified targets by petrified targets. We'll just increase the cooldown. Or reduce the cooldown, I should say. Medal of Honor. Immersive examination of 30. Increase critical hit chance by 30% when remaining ammo is 50% or higher. I don't know what that does, but I'll take it. It's probably not gonna do much for me. I'm just gonna see if I can tank this dude. Have that heal on like a 5-second cooldown. Look at this. 20-second cooldown. Get wrecked. Any guns? No. Ice planet. Oh, I got frozen there. Don't expect any mercy. Come out of the way. Oh, that's really good. Pretty much always had this going now. This time I'm going to predict that I will not be able to die. Percent of max HP. A lot of points, but I want to do damage to bosses, so. Oh, new guns. I don't care what they are. They're probably better than her stupid Gatling gun. see. What are they? Blink handgun, low damage handgun, and recovers health when reloading. That's insane. Alright, where am I supposed to go? Up here? Why is she, like, moving like that sometimes? She's, like, dodging every couple of seconds. Tracker handgun, crit chance increase. Critical hit chance increase by 20% nor 40% target defense. That's the ones I had last time. Yeah, I'll take these. Assault handgun. Skill power increases by 40%, skill range by 40%. Ah, dope. Yeah, I'll take these. Oh, boss fight. Let's reduce the cooldown on that, and let's see what's in here. All these are good. Oh shit. Burn through the ammo on this. I couldn't get the other one. Alright, boss again. This time I hope I do it. Okay. Let's try this. I basically gotta be dumping my heal skill nonstop and alternating it with my buffing skill. Oh, I'm taking big hits. Oh, it's not good. Oh, this is insane. Die! Yes! I did it! Ah, oh, thank God. Way to go, Shuri number two. What? Come on, you should get way more than that for a clear. Shuri's OP. Oh, Shuri number three. Okay. Ooh, weapon drop rate increased by 10%. Okay, let's try somebody else. Shuri seems pretty strong. She doesn't have a heal, so she's really fragile. Oh, this guy's the current bonus. Guillotine to Butcher of the Battlefield. Let's see. Oh, he's a melee character. He's got a block. Oh, okay. I'll give this guy a shot. I haven't tried any other areas yet. Oh, I have a certain amount of shield time. Snowman Axe, Battle Axe with Freeze Module. Heals twice as much HP and increases weapon damage 100% for 15 seconds. Heals retaliation damage and recovery by 2 times. Let's go with this upgrade. See, he's got a counter. That's dope. That's really good. I'm gonna have to do that. Feeling this guy's gonna be a little harder than sure he was there. I don't know what to pick on this guy, because he's melee. Probably ability cooldown. And ability damage. It does a lot of damage. Okay, that's a huge heal. That seems pretty spammable. Next planet, please. Let's see how I do on the boss. Burns targets on hit, targets slowed by 40%, increases damage to burn targets by 200%. Let's try this burn. Okay. I didn't even look at the other one, it was just raw damage on bosses. Man, this guy's super tanky. Damn, I like some of those other ones, but that 200% skill damage is really good. This guy needs a movement speed buff, and then I think maybe an attack speed buff. So he can swing like a lunatic, and then I'll be good to go. Nice. Correct. I think that's probably the only one. Oh, it's a hammer. Okay, so what does this give? This gives 80% skill power. This gives max HP 40%, critical hit chance 10%. I think I'd rather have the skill power, to be honest, even though it's really cool. Be a bit more judicial with what I'm picking. My silence? Oh my god, I think I'm silenced or something. Whatever. Oh, this is the way I gotta go. Oh, I'm actually gaining more HP on heal now. That's cool. Silenced. How did I throw those snowballs just now? No, robot dude! I'll save you. Next planet. This planet's going on for way too long. Like, this should be a boss, maybe? Yeah, it's usually some kind of boss thing. Break through the protective wall and activate the battle workers. Time limit. Oh. Let's go, boys. Oh. Ah, sick. What do these give? These give weapon power 40%, attack speed 20%. I kind of like what I have right now. Whoa. Amazing automatically reels. Oh, it's a gun. Receive damage when animal count is less than 40%. Ignore 40% target's defense. Oh, it's a flamethrower! Sick. Okay, all those are good. Let's go, robots. Alright, let's see. I took the flame thing because I'm stupid. I think the axe may have been better, but whatever. Oh, I can't afford any of those. Alright, let's do it. This boss again. I know his patterns now a little bit, so. And the graphics in this game are dope. These bosses look sick. Get wrecked. Oh, I get the bonus now too. Nice. Actually got a lot of weapons to drop there. Now, question is, should I unlock some more breakers? Maybe lightning? Mountain seems very similar to guillotine. In fact, they both get into the same stance. But I did say I want to unlock Uzi. Because of the thick thighs! Let's get lightning. Let's get Uzi. We'll play as lightning. increases his attack speed for a little bit. And then he shoots a bunch. And then he does that. That's sick. And he's got a really short dash, but it's also got a really short cooldown. Okay. Try Uzi out. Yeah, she's got what I figured. She's got a shield. Not sure what that does. And then, boom. She doesn't feel as impressive as, I'm not even sure who I was gonna say. Nobody. Toast, Rush. Let's unlock Rush. Oh, that's dope. Oh. Oh. This guy seems sick. Okay. I see. I'm messing up the combos. Okay, so if you attack just like that, he's just gonna, you know, swing like an idiot. But you see how it charges up there at the end? If you attack right on the end, when it charges up, you can do a special attack. Okay. It's a bit hard to do on the controller, probably easier to do on the thing, on the PC. I'm gonna try lightning though. Actually, I've been streaming for an hour. I'm gonna call it quits. More of this later.